In this short video, we're going to look at how to translate the reading frames in a piece of DNA. So say we've got this sequence here. Now we can break this up into codons quite easily. That is, we just break it up into groups of three bases. So we break it up as TTG, TAA, ACG, so on and so forth. But the thing is, we can break this up into multiple sort of groups of three. We've got the one here that starts TTG, but if we move in one and start at TGT as the three, then we get a different reading frame. So we get TGT, AAA, CGC, etc. And finally, we can move in on a second one, so past the first two T's, and then this gives us GTA, AAC, GCC, etc. Now, if we moved another base in, we would return to the first one. So this gives us our three reading frames because we've got three bases in a codon. Now, if we have a codon wheel or table available, we can then start translating these codons. So starting with the first one, TTG, that gives us leucine. TAA is a stop codon. We continue translating across. CCG is proline, AAA, etc. We can then do that for the second reading frame. Here we start with TGT, which gives us cysteine. We then move on to AAA and so on and so forth through the codons. And finally, we can do it for the last sequence that we can see here. This time we start with GTA, which gives us V, so on and so forth. So from that DNA sequence, we've now got three potential peptides. However, it doesn't stop there. Because what you've got to remember is there is also a reverse sequence. So this is our sequence, and in the opposite direction, we have this sequence. Now we need to spin this around so that it's in the correct orientation for us to read it. And then when we do that and split it into codons again, we now get TTC, CAC, TTT, so on and so forth. Next, we can move in one and we start with TCC, ACT, TTC, etc. Finally, we can move in past the second T and this gives us CCA, CTT, TCG, etc. We can then translate those using the codon wheel. So for the first reading frame, we get FH, FRR. The second reading frame, we can also translate, so we get serine, threonine, etc. And then we can also do the same for the last reading frame. So this has given us another three reading frames. So if we look at our sequence, effectively what we've got is potentially six peptides could be encoded from it. Three from the forward strand from the three different reading frames, and three from the reverse strand, the three different reading frames in that direction. So effectively, we have three forward peptides being produced and three reverse peptides being produced. So that is how we can get six different peptides from one DNA sequence. We just translate the three reading frames in one direction and the three reading frames in the other direction.